All right, what's up, everybody? I'm Jonathan, and this is Worship Matters, and we're gonna do something interesting today. Today, I'm gonna show you the song that started it all, where little old Jonathan said, "I need to make a YouTube channel and talk about Christian music because it's gotten this bad." So I already know this song. I already have my critiques of the song, but to be fair, it has been a very long time since I've actually listened to the song. So maybe I'm wrong, but I think you'll agree with me that I'm probably not. We're gonna be listening to Chris Tomlin's song, God's Great Dance Floor. Just stay in it. Like, what? Okay. If you're new here, go ahead and subscribe. We'd love for you to join the family. I love talking about Christian music. My heart behind this channel is just to make Christian music great and encourage Christian artists to in how to write songs. So I'm critiquing to build up, I want to help people in that area. So give us a like if you enjoy this video, and let's jump into this. All right, here is our worship guidelines. We've got directional, musically repeatable, theologically sound, the Bob test, artistic license, and congregational versus personal. If you don't know what any of that means, I did a whole video about it. Links in the description. You can go check that out. But and we'll come back to that later. So we'll go through it later. But let's do this thing. Here we go. The big moment. The one that started it all. All right. That's verse one. All right, not too bad. I'm coming back to the start. I don't know what the start is, but maybe the start of the race. Maybe the start of where I. Oh, well, where you found me. I guess I should just keep going. Coming back to the start. Where is the start? Where you found me? I'm going back to the beginning. I'm going back to the beginning. Vasini. That's a Princess Bride reference for the day. Where you found me, I'm coming back to your heart. Now I surrender. Okay. It's not bad. It's not really saying much. It's a very like personal declaration. So in my personal life, I am going back to where God found me. Whatever that means. Maybe it's because I've gone down the wrong path. I'm coming back to your heart, and now I surrender. Okay, I guess we didn't surrender to begin with. Like, I don't know if he's trying to imply that he wasn't a Christian before, or like I don't know. Let's keep going. Yeah, there we go. Take me. I'll just play it. This is all that I can bring. And then I think it goes into the chorus. Or. All right, here we go. Let's just keep listening. So it doesn't really say much. This is all that I can bring. I don't know what this is, but maybe it's the surrender that he's talking about. That's the verse two. So we have again, I'm coming back to the start. Where is the start? Our God is freedom. Okay, so that doesn't exactly make sense. And then here we feel your heart. Where is the in here? Is he talking about like in the church building? Because he's not in a church building. He's in a probably in a concert hall when he's playing this. So in the concert hall we feel your heart. I assume the heart is God. That's a good assumption, I think. Okay. What was the other thing? Our God is freedom. I mean, this is true. God is freedom. You're not really telling me what he's freedom from. I don't know that God is freedom. But I think what he means is that freedom comes from God. I think that's what he means by that. Because is God freedom? Like, in God there is freedom. And there is only freedom in God. But is God freedom? Like, he is truth. He is love. Is he also freedom? I don't know. I mean, the Bible doesn't say that. Alright. And here we feel your heart. Your heartbeat for us. So, in wherever this location is. This undefined location. Maybe it's in his freedom. I don't know. We feel your heartbeat for us. So, he's saying that God has a heartbeat that's for us. Which isn't necessarily bad. It's just ill-defined. Take me. This is all that I can bring. Now, I don't know what this is. Before, we were pretty sure it was the surrender. So what is the this time? Because he hasn't really talked about himself. Okay. Let's go to the chorus. All I can bring. Alright, I think that's it. Okay. Seriously? You killed me, Smalls. There we go. You'll never give up on us. Okay, I'm assuming that you is God. All of heaven... did it not... Okay, I didn't go back far enough, sorry. You'll never stop loving us. Again, I'm assuming the you is God. No matter how far we run, that's true. God won't give up on us. He has chosen to love us, and so he went to the ultimate end. So once he's done that, he's proven how much he loves us. And so what are we? You know, we run away, but God pursues us. You'll never give up on us. All of heaven shouts, let the future begin. Now, I'm assuming by the us here, he's referring to the church. Because here's the thing, God allows people to choose not him. You know, God has allowed whole hordes of people to not choose him. And so part of love is letting those that you love choose other things. Choose to hate you, and that's what he's done. He's allowed humanity as a whole to rebel against him. Of course, there's judgment coming for that, and he's provided a way out of that. And so for the church, he's already paid the price. He's already gone the whole way, so there's no need to give up. He's already fulfilled everything that we need. We just have to accept him and believe in him and repent from our sins. So there's no need to give up because we're saved. Even though from our perspective, sometimes it feels like we constantly need grace, which we do. I know that for sure. So in that sense, yes, he never gives up. But for all the people who are lost, who have chosen to not love God, to hate him, to rebel against his law, there, it's not that he's given up. He's just allowing them to do what they want to do, and they're going to reap their own rewards for that. So, all right, all of heaven shouts, let the future begin. I'm not sure what he means by this. I assume let the future begin means like bring about the second or the coming of the kingdom. Let eternity begin. But what do you mean by the future? And I don't remember the heaven ever shouting that. what they do shout is, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. That's something the heaven shouts, you know. But I don't remember them ever talking about the future. Unless maybe you're talking about, like, metaphorically, they're calling for the return of Christ and Christ to set up his eternal kingdom that never ends. Maybe that's what he's talking about here. Not the language he uses, but, oh, okay, I guess eventually we get another let the future begin that I missed. Okay. This looks like maybe a verse 3. I don't know what it is. Take me. This is all I can bring. All right, so that was it. That was verse 3. And then we have, you never stop loving us. You never give up on us. All the future, all of heaven shouts, let the future begin. All right, and then we have the part that started this whole channel. Here we go. Ready? Buckle up. It's a doozy. I think that's basically it. I feel alive. I come alive. I am alive on God's great dance floor. So that's the bridge. I feel alive. I come alive. I am alive on God's great dance floor. What? What great dance floor? I don't understand. Like, what are you talking about? Is this the future that all heaven is shouting for? I don't understand. Where did the dancing come from? There was no mention of dancing in this song. Oh, man. I don't get it. Like, oh. Like, if you want to sing a song about dancing, whatever. You know? The beat is pretty groovy, I guess, you know. How about I come alive because of Christ, who's given me life and breath and, you know, everything. I come alive because of the resurrection, where we will no longer be dead, but we will be raised to life. How about I come alive because Christ is giving me new life, so I'm no longer the dead zombie that I used to be in sin, dead in my sins and trespasses, but Christ has made me alive with him, and that's how I come alive. That's how I am alive. I don't come alive on a dance floor. Oh, I just imagine, like, maybe Chris Tomlin thinks that Jesus and Satan had this great dance off or something. I don't know. Like, what is this? It's so bad. What are you talking about? Okay. let's just unpack this. So before we get into the worship guidelines, the reason I hate this so much, and I like Chris Tomlin, he's written a lot of good songs, but, like, the reason this is bad is because as Christians, we should sing about and long for the things that God has promised. God never promised there's going to be a dance floor in heaven. Will there be? I don't know. I'm sure there'll be dancing in heaven, so why not? But God has not promised that there's going to be a great big dance floor for everybody to dance on. God has promised to set all things right, to bring about judgment. He has promised to return for his people, to give them a place, to give them an inheritance, namely himself, to bring about a new heaven and a new earth where there is no sin, there is no sickness, there is no disease. That's what we're promised. That's what we should look forward to. I come alive, if you will, thinking about the return of Christ. I don't come alive on a dance floor. Like, what? Ugh. I just don't get what you were going for here. Like, you know, okay, everybody needs, like, a strike, you know? Hey, Like every now and then you swing and you miss. It's okay. Get back up to the plate. Chris Tomlin's written some good songs, but this is a big swing and a miss. let's jump over to the worship guidelines. All right, directional. I don't even know where to put this. It's all about me and coming alive on a dance floor. It's very personal. It's all about like his perspective to the detriment of the song, because I just don't know what he's saying. Like maybe you're singing this personal song to God, but you don't give us enough context to really explain what you mean. Just explain what you mean. Like there are some things that are obvious, but there are other things. It's just like, you're going to the start of where you found me. Okay. Like, what do you mean by that? Like, how am I supposed to interpret that? Are you just saying like your whole life is a mess? Cause he's been a Christian for a long time. So are you just saying like my whole life's a mess, I'm going back to the beginning. I'm going back to the beginning, Vicini. Or are you like saying like I've stumbled and fallen, I'm getting up and going back again. Like I'm coming, I'm trying to get back to the center of worship. You know, that's a bit different. You know, those are two different things, but they could both be interpreted by what you're saying there. I don't know. Like, it's not easy to know. So it's hard to know direct. Well, okay. So directionally, it's about him. So it's all about his. He's speaking to God. And so I guess the assumption is that we're supposed to sing to him, but I'm alive on God's great dance floor. Who's that directed to? Or is he telling the audience, hey, you, I come alive? Are you telling yourself, hey, you, I come alive? It's like this declarative statement just out to the universe. Like, that has no meaning. What do you mean you come alive? What is this great dance floor that I'm hearing about that God apparently owns? That you've not mentioned dancing at all in the song. We don't know what this is. Like, what are you talking about? Musically repeatable? Yeah, it's too easy. Theologically sound? There's nothing in this song. Like, even the closest thing we got to, like, a good theological premise that God is freedom. Like, what do you mean by that? What do you mean God is freedom? Like, God, in God there is freedom. But that's a different claim than God is freedom. Like, you could say, like, the you could condense it to say God is freedom to mean in God there is freedom. Freedom only comes through God. You could mean it that way, but I don't know. You didn't explain it. So theologically sound, there's not enough theology in the song to really say that it's sound, so I'll give it a fail. Bob test, well, I'm assuming he's talking about our Lord Jesus Christ, but he never says it. We have God. We could trade God with Bob. Bob might, maybe you come alive on Bob's great dance floor. I don't know. You know, is perhaps Bob is your freedom. I don't know what you mean by that. You know, like, I think this fails Bob test too. There's not enough, like, you could be singing this about your boyfriend Bob who owns a dance floor. Like, I don't know. Artistic license. I guess I'll give the God is freedom artistic license. I don't know. I'll be a little lenient. All right, congregational versus personal. This is definitely not congregational. Definitely not congregational. I would never sing this in a church because it's singing the wrong thing. It's not singing about something that we know God has promised. And that's what we want to sing in church is, these are the things that God has promised us. We're going to celebrate about those things. We're going to look forward to those things. We're going to you know, base our hope on these things that God has promised, because we know that God keeps his promises. But God has not promised there's going to be a great big dance floor. So Chris Tomlin shows up in heaven and there's no dance floor. Are you going to be sad? Because you can no longer come alive? I don't know. Like, personal. See, I wouldn't even use this for personal worship, to be honest. Like, if you want to sing this and you want to, like, insert any theology into the song that's not in the song, sure, fine, whatever. Personal. There's nothing to the song. Like, but I would not even do that. I would just, like, if you like dancing, it's a fun song to dance with. It's got a good beat, which is probably all the song was meant to do. But I would not even, I would separate it from myself. away from like worship. It just seems to be a song that can get people grooving. I don't know. That's my take on it. So let me know what you think. Do you disagree with this song? This is a song, like I said at the beginning, this is a song that really started this channel for me. I hate this song. I don't hate a lot of songs, but it was on the radio all the time, and I just cut the radio off. And actually, this is a song that made me stop listening to the radio, because I was just like, they played it too often. I was done with it. I was like, you know what? Christian music can be better. We can actually have good Christian songs. But the radio, for whatever reason, is playing this garbage, promoting songs that don't talk about all the things that God has promised us, you know, and they're talking about singing on a dance floor. How am I supposed to do anything with that in a car on my way home on the radio, you know? How am I supposed to do anything with that on a church, in a church service on Sunday? Like, you know, maybe I can dance in my kitchen while I'm cooking, you know, but that's all I'm doing. I'm dancing. I'm not really worshiping. You know, I'm not saying anything about who God is. I'm not saying anything about how great God is. There's a couple things about God's heart or whatever, which, you know, again, like, you're not really saying anything. So I think this is a big flop. Probably Chris Tomlin's worst song ever written, which is sad because Chris Tomlin has written some good songs. Yeah, so there you go. Let me know what you think. Do you like this song? Is this your favorite song? Let me know why. I'm curious. Do you have other songs you want me to listen to? Leave them in the comments. I'd love to check them out and do a video on them. You know, that's what I'm here for. I don't hate Chris Tomlin. He's a good songwriter. He's an excellent singer. I hate this song. I think that it is a great showcase of everything that is wrong with Christian music today. So it's a great showcase of that. It's vague. There's nothing there. It's super shallow. It talks about things God has not promised us, and it's celebrating all these things that are tertiary and have nothing to do with the promises of God. And that's the central theme of the song, is those things that are not promised. Those things that we have no guarantee will actually come about. So that is the core example that I have of bad Christian music is this song. So thanks for watching. I appreciate you. I'll catch you next time. Peace.